medicines that can actually affect the pregnant woman can also have an effect on the fetus. We do have good what are called torch infections. This can actually cause a mirage of conditions that affect the unborn baby or the fetus. In this context, I did not see obvious signs of infection to the fetus. However, this case presented with what we call a pyosalpinx. So a pyosalpinx is actually a purulent collection in the fallopian tube or in the fallopian tubes. So this is the case presenting. This was a pregnant woman. So what you're seeing here is our amniotic fluid. There are echogenic particles that you are seeing here in the amniotic fluid. This is in keeping with what we call the venix casiosa. So this is our venix casiosa. You can actually see perfusion here. These are blood vessels, the uterine blood vessels which are flowing here. But you can, however, appreciate this elongated tubular structure with internal echoes. This is consistent with what I am referring to as my pyosalpinx. So it's actually pus that is collecting in the fallopian tubes. In the natural setting, it's very difficult to see the fallopian tubes because they are very tiny, they are very small, and they are housing the broader ligaments. You can only appreciate them when they are fluid distended or fluid filled, as you are appreciating here. So it is just free fluid, anechoic free fluid collecting here. That condition, we call it a hydrosalpinx. But this now, it has got internal echoes and associated with the pain that you have. So this is actually in keeping with what I am referring as a pyosalpinx. The unfortunate part is ultrasound cannot be used to actually identify the microscopic organism or antigen that is causing this condition. So we need also lab tests to rule out torch infections that can affect the unborn baby. So you see here we have the collection, a tubular structure that we are appreciating. This is consistent with a pyo. On color Doppler interrogation, again, you can appreciate what we have here is the pyosalpinx, and there's no flow on color Doppler. As you're seeing, you can appreciate here, this is our amniotic fluid with the venous casiosa that you are seeing here. Then this is just artificial echoes that you are seeing. It's not color flow, it's surge. So the vessels are here, and then you can appreciate that there's no flow in the pyosalpinx, as you can see. So this examination is actually a TVS, so that's a transvaginal scan. In this setting, you can actually appreciate in transverse section. This you are seeing here, this is our cervix, and then this echogenic structure that we have, that's at the end of cervix. So this is our cervix, and then you can appreciate what I'm talking about as the pyosalpinx, and then we have got our amniotic fluid, which is here. That's our amniotic fluid, the cervix, the collection, which is there. I hope it's all making sense and it's adding up. You can appreciate it. You can appreciate the anatomy. And again, in this view, you can actually see nicely the longitudinal section of our cervix here. So you can actually see the end of cervix. So when we are measuring the cervical length, we actually coming from the os all the way to the vaginal canal here somewhere. So this is our nice cervix. You can appreciate it. This is the endocervix, and then we have got our amniotic fluid here. The fetal parts are here. This we have is the structure that I am referring to as my pyosalpinx. So this is actually a very nice capture of the cervix. So when we are measuring cervical shortening, is actually the distance from here to here, and then when you find this to be below 2.5, then you can actually raise the alarm button that we're dealing with the case of cervical shortening. However, in this context, the cervix was normal sized and is closed, as you can appreciate. We don't have issues to do with threatened miscarriage, whatnot ever. But what we have now is this infection. That is what I am worried about. I guess I also worried about it, because if this happens to be touch infections, we are in for a high jump. We need to monitor this pregnancy as much as we can, so that we don't put the life of the fetus at risk. I hope you are doing very well around the world. I hope also that the temperature of ultrasound is getting hotter and hotter by the day. I appreciate you are going to acclimatize with time, and then this is Medical Ultrasound Academy. We are here to stay. Our videos are coming, more education and more learning for the better of the profession, for the better of the patient. Thank you all.